Welcome back to Jewelry for Rhino Design Tutorials. Today I'm going to explain in detail how to use the Rail Sweep 3 tool with several examples and teach you how to design this men's ring with the Rail tool. For now, let's start by learning how to use the tool. To use the Rail Sweep 3 tool, we need to have three curves, which I've prepared in advance. Switch to Sweep 3. Double profile. Open. Select the left rail, the right rail, and the center. The bottom half of the shank is a curved profile, and the top half is a folded profile. Sweep 3 has one more direction to control than Sweep 2. The curve in the center controls its height. It is much easier to modify the surface shape by adjusting the curves. The left and right curves control the width of the shank. Sweep 3 has one more height control than Sweep 2, so it's easier to control the base shape. Next example. Pendants are also suitable for use with Sweep 3. The left and right curves control the width of the ribbon, and the center curve controls the height of the ribbon. Change the color of the middle curve to make it easier to see. Open the Rail tool. Select the left one, the right one, then select the center. Select the profile. Generate the other two ribbons as well. After these ribbons are created, the width and height basically don't need to be modified. It's very easy to adjust the height difference using the curves in the middle. The ending position usually needs more adjustment. It's much easier this way. Like this, the pendant is ready in no time. Now, let's get started with today's design case study. I'm going to show you how to quickly make this men's ring using the Rail tool. Place the reference image in the upper left corner and lock it in place. Take the stones from the gems library. Let's get started on the gemstone setting. Use the polygon mirror curve. Compare the picture with the setting, it's about this big. Turn on orthogonal. Add two control points in the center to sharpen the angles. Draw the profile of the setting. I'm going to use Rail Revolve, which I've taught in previous lessons, to make this diamond setting. Make sure the endpoints are on the same vertical line. Add a control point near the angle. Sharpen the angle a bit. Show the control points and adjust them a little bit. Open the Rail tool. Select Rail Revolve. Single profile. Select Rail, then select Profile. The setting is now ready. Next, I'm going to make the diamond prongs. This time I'll make them out of JFR pipe. Next time I'll show you how to use the tool that automatically generates the prongs. Open the JFR pipe tool. Switch to the round cap facing up. The diamond embedding of approximate 0.1 millimeters is enough. Rotate it 45 degrees. After generating the prongs, use the four quadrant mirror to make four copies. The head of the men's ring is now ready. Compare it to the original picture and adjust it. Create a ring size. Use a number 9 for the men's ring size. Raise the head of the ring up. Lower the prongs a bit more. Copy a curve as a reference curve. Lock it in place. Trim half of it off. Offset by 1.8 millimeter. Move up 0.4 millimeters to make a gradient. Right-click on the simple curve icon to enter the editing state. This position needs an angle. Add a control point to make the angle a bit sharper. Flatten the countertop. Notice that the number of control points must be the same for both curves. And try to align the control points as much as possible. Point 8. Point 9. And then adjust it to the reference curve. This curve is used to control the width of the shank. Use the taper tool to make the top wide and the bottom narrow. The width of the bottom is about 3.5 millimeter. The three rail curves of the ring shank are ready. Look at the shape of the shank and start drawing its profile. Draw a rectangle with cycle curve. Right-click on the vertical mirror curve icon to edit it. Angle the sides. The center is concave. Hold down Alt and make a duplicate. Flatten the top half. Open the rail tool. Switch to sweep 3. Multi-profile. Select point 0. The bottom of the ring is flat. By the third point, it is also flat. At the point 6, the ring will gradually become concave. Point 7 is also concave. Point 9 transitions to flat. Point 11 is also flat. The direction of the surface is reversed. Reverse the profile. This position is not smooth. We can show the control points to adjust it. Flatten to custom plane. Flatten the top and bottom of the shank. Adjust the angle position. The beveled edges of the ring shank are aligned with the beveled corners of the setting for a better look. Align the top with the setting. The inside of the ring shank needs to be tucked in. Deepen the concave a bit. That makes the first layer of shank almost ready. Smooth this position out. Now let's make the second layer. Copy this curve. Switch to front view and use project to see plane. Then offset the curve. Draw a rectangular profile. This time I'm going to use sweep too. To make it wider, transform it with the taper tool. The height difference tapers off in the lower half. Now the ring is almost ready. All that's left is to adjust the details. Raise the countertop a bit. Now the difference between the height of the ring shank is not enough. Select these control points and increase their level difference. Move left 0.1 millimeter. This is the process of making a men's ring. Thanks for watching this far. If this video was helpful to you, please like, share this video, and subscribe to us. See you next time.